How to ban someone from your YouTube channel, you ask? Well, go to your computer, YouTube Studio, and there in the comments, look for the comment from the person you want to ban. And then here you have the dot 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 menu. Click it, and here you find it. Hide user from channel. And by the way, you can do the same on the YouTube Studio app on mobile. If you don't know how to access YouTube Studio on your computer or mobile, there's more information in the description of this video. And what you do with hide user from channel is actually shadow banning that user. So the user can continue to write comments on your channel, but they just don't show, you don't see them. The person is shadow banned, so to say. But what if you don't have a comment from that person you want to ban? Well, then go to YouTube Studio again, and here in the corner you have the settings and there community. And here you have a section called hidden users. This list here are all the users that are already banned, and you can add the person to ban here as well. And by the way, this is also the place where you can remove a user again in case you accidentally banned someone from your channel you didn't want to ban in the first place. Maintaining this hidden users list is not possible in the YouTube Studio app, at least right now. So you have to go to your computer and access YouTube Studio there to do that. But in any way, what you do essentially with hiding the user from your channel, this applies to everything. Your comments below your video, your comments on community posts, live stream chat messages, and so on. By the way, in the live stream, there is a dot 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 menu as well, where you can hide a user from your channel if they annoy you during the live stream too much. But let me ask, does this solve your problem? I assume you have trolls on your channel, you get a lot of spam, something like that, and hiding each and every user individually might not solve your problem. So I want to explain you a little more what else you can do. There's so much more that you can do in order to help your channel, and by the way, also other channels to fight the spam we have on YouTube. When we go to the comments section here again, you have already seen, I bet, that we have the held for review tab as well as the likely spam tab. Both of these tabs are there for you to moderate comments to fight the spam. And the difference between those two is held for review are all comments that were flagged because of your personal channel settings. Settings about how to moderate comments on your channel, and they land in here. Just to give you an idea, again, here in the community settings, you have, for example, blocked words, which you can add in order to hold comments for review, which contain these words. There are many more comment settings that you can use. For me, the default was always fine to use, but if you want to learn more, in the description, I have a link to a YouTube help article that is called Learn About Comment Settings, where you can learn more about these detailed settings. But for now, let's go into the Held for Review tab and just go through all the comments there to give you an idea how they are moderated. Here, for example, the first one is a blatant link drop, and I really don't like that. This is spam in its pure form. So what I do now is I could just delete this comment, but I want to go further. I report this comment as spam. Yeah, it just disappeared because I reported it. And what you do here, you do a service to not only your channel, but also to other channels. Because if you and other creators report the comments of that particular channel that I just reported as well, well, then YouTube will realize at some point, well, of course, this channel gets reported so much, maybe I should not show the comments again on other channels where they might not even have commented before. Those comments from that channel at one point, when too many reports come in, well, they go into the likely spam folder then. Yeah, YouTube automatically detects that as spam and puts those comments into the likely spam folder here. So you do a service for the whole YouTube community here. But be careful, you shouldn't misuse this feature and report comments that are not worth reporting. Because let's look at this article here, manage spam in comments. By the way, link to this article also in the description. Here they have a warning, a big warning. Use the report feature with caution. Anyone who misuses it may be prohibited from using YouTube altogether. Using YouTube altogether. So it could go as far as your channel gets closed if you report too many comments that are not worth reporting. Yeah, use it only if you really get spam, if you really have an issue with the comments. Otherwise, you will see we can just delete comments, for example. So be careful here, please. So going back to help for review, this tab here, the next comment, for example, this is also, I mean, this is on the edge, right? He calls me by my name, so he actually watched my video, but still it's just a link drop. This is a prime example where reporting would be too much. Yeah, we have to be fair here. It is not blatant link drop like the one before. So what I do here, because it's still a link drop, sorry, my friend, I delete this comment. That's the thing you can do next. And then of course, the next one here is one that is totally fine. I click approve because it's a fine comment. And this way, this comment just got moved to the publish tab where the comment is visible publicly. I can respond to them and so on. And then finally, I want to stress this one. This is really blatant spam, what you can see here. I did a video about active subscribers, how to gain them, of course. My channel is all about organic growth strategies, real growth strategies. And then this tool comes by and recommends that people should use this tool in order to get subscribers. But I checked them out and they are actually really borderline bad. They promote techniques that fall into YouTube's, how is it called? Fake engagement policy. If we look at the YouTube help article for fake engagement policy, then you can read YouTube doesn't allow anything that artificially increases the number of views, likes, comments, or other metrics like gaining subscribers and so on. Artificially increasing them, like for example, sub for sub, sometimes help with a tool, like in this case. This is not good. Here further down you can even see that sub for sub is forbidden to do on YouTube. This is spam. This is not allowed and this should not be done by anyone. So when we go back to this promotion, so to say, of a tool that promotes these fake engagement practices, then yeah, of course, I have to report it and hopefully this channel is not able to spam more and more other channels as well, because this is just not okay. The likely spam tab here works the exact same way like the held for review tab. You moderate them the same way, but let me give you an example here. We have another link drop here. Yeah, subscribe to my new channel and ask to subscribe. And obviously that person commented like this on other channels already as well. And that is the reason why this comment, that person commented on my channel for the first time and it already went into the likely spam folder. So this is the effect of reporting spam comments. Other channels have received a similar comment most likely from that person already, reported these comments as spam. And this way now, since the person commented on my channel as well, it right away went into the likely spam folder like you see here. It doesn't show publicly. This comment is never shown publicly because it lands into the likely spam folder right away. Same for held for review. Those comments don't show publicly until you decided what to do with those comments. Whether you approve them, then they are shown publicly, or you decide to report those comments again, then they get never shown publicly. And in this case, this is obviously also spam, so let me report it. And since we talked about sub for sub in the fake engagement policy just now, let me give you an example of that as well. Here we have this classical ask, I sub to whoever subs to me. Sub for sub is not good, doesn't help anyone, and I don't want that on my channel. It's against the terms of service as well, so I report that as well. Along with other spam, like here obviously, spam a lot, so report and so on. With this, you slowly clean up your own channel, help other channels as well, and do good to fight the spam on YouTube. That said, however, when you have reported comments as spam, even like we discussed in the beginning, banned that users, hid this user from your channel, well, that person cannot comment on your channel anymore then. But of course, that person can still do dislikes on your videos, right? I mean, if you have trolls on your channel, this is really an issue. And since you probably wonder, your comments are safe now, how about my dislikes? They can still leave some on my channel. Well then, check out this video where I explain you what effect those dislikes have on your channel. I hope this helped. Stay safe from spam. Cheers, my friends.